Before you begin, remove the base enclosure and battery. Removal: important. Make careful note of the routing of all cables connected to the system board for later replacement. Disconnect the following cables from the system board: webcam cable, wireless LAN antenna cables, right speaker cable, fingerprint reader ribbon cable, NFC board ribbon cable, keyboard ribbon cable, keyboard light ribbon cable, card reader board ribbon cable, touchpad ribbon cable, storage drive ribbon cable, left speaker cable, power button board ribbon cable, and rear speaker cable. Remove the two 2mm P1 Phillips head screws that secure the display panel connector bracket to the system board. Remove the display panel connector bracket. Disconnect the display panel cable from the connector on the system board. Remove the three 4mm P1 Phillips head screws that secure the system board bracket to the top cover. Lift the system board bracket off of the system board and remove. Remove the three 4mm P1 Phillips head screws that secure the two fans to the top cover. Remove the two 4mm P1 Phillips head screws that secure the system board to the top cover. Remove the 4mm P1 Phillips head screw that secures the plastic hook to the top cover. Lift the plastic hook off of the system board and remove. Grasping the system board near the center, carefully lift the right edge off of the alignment pins and slide the external connectors out of the cutouts in the top cover. Note: before installing a system board, remove the following from the old system board and install on the new system board: heat sink assembly, memory modules, M.2 solid state module, real-time clock battery. Reverse this procedure to install the system board. Important: after system board replacement, be sure to complete post-installation tasks as required that may include verifying functionality of the notebook, updating the BIOS, updating DMI and other settings.